cheating, a fever pitch, and it's bringing me out the dark. Finally, I can see you crystal clear. Go ahead and sell me out, and I'll lay your ship bare. The scars of your love remind me of us. They keep me thinking that we almost had it all. The scars of your love, they leave me breathless. I can't help feeling we could have had it all. You have my heart instead.
Beauty, elegance,
stylish,
comfortable.
Shoes are necessary. Shoes are awesome.
Shoes are expression.
Shoes are obsession.
Did you know that the average woman owns 30 pairs of shoes?
Let me count. 1, 2, 3. I don't know, around 11.
I think I have 5 pairs of shoes.
15.
I think 20. 22.
With boots or without? If it's without, then probably over 50.
Countless, I don't know.
I have no idea.
20? You know, running shoes, dress shoes, golf shoes.
How many?
Brown, black, you know, all different colors.
So my students in grade 12 immersion last year gave me this cup, and it's from Hallmark. You can tell Hallmark knows women and the importance of shoes. And they gave me this cup which says pumped and ready. And it has heels because I always used to wear heels last year. Obviously, I was not smart enough yet to also have flats on hand. So that's the story of that cup.
I have this pillow that says, behind every successful woman is a fabulous pair of shoes. So I do have, you know, my friends definitely know I'm into shoes. Another friend gave me this Scotch tape holder, which has a little fun to it. And I even have Kleenex with shoes and purse. I went to about a shoe museum once, that was a few years ago now, but it is interesting because you can learn a lot about history from shoes, of course, from the years gone by, and all of the changes that have taken place.
percent of women admitted to hiding a shoe purchase.
So me and my mom went shopping and she wouldn't let me get a pair of shoes, and I've been saving up for them. She said they were too high, too expensive, just a waste of money. So basically me and my friend, we went shopping and I bought those pair of shoes, and I had to hide them from my mom, and I think it was worth it.
Sometimes I buy shoes from online and my mom doesn't know that, and when they come to my house, my mom is like, what, you got another pair? You've got a lot already.
Shoe shopping is almost a sport for women.
It's all about looking for the best deals and hoping that you'll find that perfect pair of shoes right in your price range.
Every lady wants to be Cinderella and wants to wear the glass slipper and have it fit her perfectly.
Of women say they had been at least moderately injured by shoes, and 8% reported serious injuries like sprains or breaks.
This happened actually this past semester. I was walking pretty quickly. I was coming into my office from the foyer, and I guess the floor was wet or something. I was like, woo!
My cousin made me wear those Indian shoes at a wedding, and they're really pointy and uncomfortable, and the back of my foot was bleeding, and it's crazy.
When I went to the zoo on a field trip, my heel got stuck in a pothole and I had to pull my foot out, which ended up bleeding.
One time I was wearing my shoes and I got 5 blisters on each foot. 5 on my toes and then on the back and then on the sides. So it was such a horrible thing, and they even started bleeding, some of them.
I've injured shoes myself, and my puppies chewed several of my shoes up. I have a small collection. And they're arranged by height.
So I have my extremely high heels, which I'll never wear to school. My moderate high heels, black heels, pink heels, white heels with roses and flowers. And then I also have my runners and my boots. I love boots.
6 out of 10 women regret at least one shoe purchase. And on average, women have worn a quarter of their shoes only once.
The most I've ever spent on shoes was a pair of Manolos, and I spent about $300 on them, and I was very young. I was in first year of university, and let's just say that I wore them for one day and they broke on me. We went dancing, and I regret buying that pair ever since.
I'm pretty cautious. I can't, you know, I don't want to go over the top too much on anything because they, that's why I say they wear out, but if you take care of them. And I have taken shoes back in to get resold, you know, for the next 1,000 kilometers. So in that way, I guess they're an investment. But I don't know. I guess cowboy boots maybe 300 or so, 350. I bought a pair of red. They kind of look like bowling shoes, red leather. I bought them in Italy in Assisi. And it was this beautiful old town, winding streets, and I went down this little alley and I saw this rack of shoes out front and I thought, well, this would be cool. So I go in the store, and this store is owned by a family for like 80 years. And this older gentleman is running it, and I saw these red shoes just lace up and they're so comfortable and they just had my size. It was a great deal. So I still have them and they look like brand new, and it's just, they have a nice memory attached to them.
I have a pair of lucky shoes that I got in Europe. They're lucky because whenever I wear them, something good ends up happening. Well, the tickets for a new concert were basically sold out. So when me and my cousin were walking in Europe, we decided to just check it out, like how it is. And there was a guy outside selling tickets, and they only had, well, 2 tickets left, and me and my cousin took the chance, and they were only $40. So we took them, and then we got into the concert.
These shoes, my grandma got them for me when I was on vacation in Europe, and I also wore them when I was filming my short film Paranoia in grade 10, which won the film festival. So I say these are lucky, and they hold a lot of memories with them. I didn't wear them that much, which makes them all the more memorable, because when I did wear them, then those were the moments that I cherished the most. So shoes can make or break an outfit. Shoes can give you confidence or they can take it away. Shoes can give you height, what nature didn't give you.
Shoes express you in ways that words can't. Doesn't matter if you lose weight or gain weight, your shoe size will always stay the same.
Shoes is a very important part of an outfit, as a woman would say. I've been told that people sometimes are judged in interview by the shape, you know, condition of their shoes. If the shoes aren't polished and taken care of, then maybe that's not somebody that pays attention to detail.
And I never get tired of getting shoes because they're so pretty.
But a moderate amount of pain. If your shoes are giving you too much pain, you need to toss them. They need to go. You can break in shoes. You can wear them for a little bit at a time. That's my secret. I wear all shoes a little bit at a time, and then, pow, I wear them all the time.
Hey girls, if you want to wear stilettos, make sure that the bottom of the shoe is bendable. This way your feet won't get that tired when you walk in them for 8 hours. Which I do.
Don't wear a dress with running shoes.
Your shoes should match your belt color.
Very important where you get your shoes from, because if you buy shoes from Walmart, they will deteriorate in 4 months. See, there's holes in my shoe here. Here you can see my sock, and yeah, it's gross.
Don't buy shoes on impulse just because they're on sale.
Don't ride a bike in high heels. It's a safety risk.
It never looks good if you don't have your toenails painted in the summer and you have open-toed shoes on.
Do not wear stilettos with your gym pants. It looks horrible.
You wear socks with sandals. It's horrible. It's like a fashion victim. just don't wear socks with sandals.
Always keep an emergency pair in your trunk. You never know when you'll need a pair of high heels.